on your collarbone, like around that level.
Oh, collarbone? Okay. Yeah. Yeah, and then I have my shirt closed and buttoned and collar up and stuff. So it would be just under my clothing.
Okay.
If you're looking for it, you could see it, I suppose.
I'd see like a glint of gold around your neck.
Yep.
What's that sound? Have
my tie all good to, you know, all done up.
Yeah. Okay. Although you guys both look pretty raggedy.
Right. Oh yeah, you got a tie too. Yeah. Fuck yeah, man. We look badass when we are.
Did I wear a top hat and freaking like Victorian era suit with tails?
Oh right, yeah. You guys took clothes from the Golden Court, yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, because our other clothes were like literally torn to shreds.
Yeah, so you're wearing literally, like old fashioned like Victorian goth kind of like
yep
stuff.
Yeah. Like, that's right.
Proper attire.
Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. So we're looking really good and you know old timey, old fashioned.
I got black gloves and a walking stick.
Yeah. Yes.
So what time period are you from?
That is actually a funny question. We come from like 1950s Germany, but actually... 1945. Or 45 Germany, but actually we come from 2019 Santa Fe, New Mexico.
That's what year it currently is for my character as well.
Yes.
Oh. Me too.
Oh.
Sam gives you a high five. Oh. The correct year. Duh.
Oh, so, hell yeah. How long have you been here then? Recently? Has it been years? Decades?
Weeks. Be a month at most.
A few weeks.
So we might have made it. We might have made it back.
All right. Yeah. Correct year is one thing.
Timeline is another.
Now we need correct plane of existence.
Yep.
And correct location. And correct timeline. So like one for four.
Yep.
Well,
timeline's going to be the hard one.
Yeah.
I'll answer most of your questions about my world. If you help me with a future favor.
Whatever. I mean, it's...
Man, we already owe so many people favors. I mean, what's one more?
Yeah, exactly. We owe fucking incorporeal deities favors at this point. What's a mage?
Okay.
And I say that out loud, too.
Corporeal.
We have no
idea.
So,
what would you like to know?
Well, I mean, whatever. Year is good. There's something I'd like to know. Is there a movie called Lonesome Sun where you're from?
Yes. When?
Yeah. And is...
It was my grandson's favorite.
Who's your grandson?
Jonathan?
That doesn't sound like Cash. I see he has a stage name. Is this his mother? Ah, damn it, I don't even know who's who anymore. He related to, Chance McNally?
No. The movie star?
Yes.
No.
Ah. Shame. I thought that there was a tiny world, and that's where he got his magic from.
No, it's quite a large world.
Oh, it gets smaller the more you learn, but yes. That would have been a hell of a coincidence, and I was hoping for it. But.
Unfortunately not. It would be nice to have that money.
He doesn't know what the hell to do with it, to tell you that.
Yeah, we had access to it. He wouldn't stop giving us some.
All he does is buy random people cars with it.
Yeah. You know him?
Yes, he's a jackass.
Well, perhaps in the future you can introduce my grandson to him.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I could get you a personal meet and greet and he could hang out. You could probably buy him a car.
Oh, my God. Again, if we're in the right timeline.
Right, right. But, let's see. I am a absolute goddamn master of time. This is a much more humble master of other things. I can't remember. Is it forces or prime?
Yes.
Yes, okay, forces and prime. What
an
amazing
absolute
abilities
master.
You... Yes.
Goddamn master.
Yeah.
Absolute goddamn master.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
The gods have damned me for my mastery of time.
And you use it to buy clothes from the past?
Uh-huh. That's my clothing stores are in the 40s. The 1440s.
Interesting.
But no, that's not where we got these.
No, we got these from a crazy elf slave lady. Slaver lady.
Yeah.
And did she know the pimp that you spoke of?
No, that was another time. That was New York.
Like, world's unrelated pimp. An unrelated pimp.
Yes.
I prefer life magic.
Ah. Ha-ha! Wow. We could have really used someone of your talents along the way.
Yeah. Best thing we got right here is freaking pay for the wounds later, man.
Mm-hmm. I can.
Do they seem wounded?
I guess wounded right now.
I'm always wounded. Let me look.
I got one lethal and a bashing.
Oh, wow. No, I'm fine. It's the willpower I'm down. I have
no
willpower.
Yeah, you probably don't have the bashing at this point.
I don't have the will to power anything.
Oh yeah, you got it. You got the lethal from something. Probably something in the hedge.
Probably.
Oh yeah, that hedge fucked me up in the willpower. That's where all mine went to, I think.
Yeah. Do either you or Gray, you are you out of willpower?
Out.
Yeah.
I can't remember.
All that's
so
keeping
all
me going.
Boxes are empty, and I can't remember if X's are used or unused.
If what's used or unused?
The X's.
Oh, yeah, my X's are used.
Right. Whereas in my mana, my X's are unused.
Yeah, gotcha.
Go figure.
Yep. All that's keeping me going at this point is my snarky wit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm probably out of willpower, I'm going to be honest. I used a lot last time.
But I am not sure what your end game is. If you're seeking to escape the land of the dead and return to the world of the living, or if you're on a quest to do something down here, your damn self. But
I'll be going back.
Okay.
Oh, shoot. You're here voluntarily?
Yes. You could say that.
Wow.
That's kind of what I meant by what brings you here. Were you trapped? Like, did you get sent? Did you come here? If so, you must have a way planned out. Could we tag along?
I doubt you'll be going back with these two. I'll just say.
She said she doubts I'd be going back with them.
You implying that if you go with these two, then you won't make it back.
Why is that?
Oh, the universe doesn't want us to return.
Yes, and the universe has some very active guardians down here.
Shit.
Would I know if the universe would also not want me to accomplish my current goal?
Well, that is against the old laws, so you would definitely have to deal with some Kerberos to accomplish your goal.
Interesting. Well, let's see how it goes. Maybe you can tag along. I'd like to get to know you more first.
Well, seems we have a long boat ride.
And we're there. No, just kidding.
Yep. Well, since I can't think of anything yet...
I'm just taking my time, you know, letting you soak in the dismal sights that I have to see every single... Well, there's no days down here, so I don't even keep track of it that way.
Constantly. But, you know. The word you're looking for is constantly.
Yes. Yeah.
At unendingly.
Yeah. At this point, you're going through, like, a tunnel with the river, and you are honestly not sure if you're moving. Like, what speed you're moving at. You're in that weird state where it's, like, hard to gauge.
At infinium.
Yep.
I just keep driving it home how endless this person has to do this for.
Yes. Thank you for stressing that.
Yes.
Really helps me contextualize everything.
For sure. I mean, sometimes you can forget how long infinity really is, so.
Oh, yes. It's definitely.
While we're chatting.
It's quite long.
While we're chatting, can I knit?
What was that?
Ooh.
Samuel?
How long have you been doing this for?
How long have souls died? Come down through the dark places in the world, trickle slowly into the ocean, depths, deepest caverns of the underworld.
So longer than last Thursday.
At least.
See, you didn't find that funny?
And yes, you can be knitting.
Yes, thank you.
See, that was funny, fairy man, or fairy lady.
Yes, fairy woman, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
It was not really funny so much as just a statement of fact.
But it was so ridiculously short of how long it's been that it was sarcastically funny.
I understand the concept of humor, but I do not find it funny.
Ah, might have to go British then. Very dry.
Actually, quite the opposite. She holds out like a dripping arm.
See? You get it. You'd be hilarious.
That wasn't funny. It was just a statement.
Well, since we may be traveling together for a little while, can I cast Mend on Amadine?
You sure can.
I'll, like, reach out and, like, poke him with my knitting needles.
Alright, are you using it to try and restore...
Hell.
Okay, that restores, Mend is restoring weak. Okay, yep.
Okay, casting spells. It's been a while.
You don't even know how to do that, and you call yourself a mage lady.
So, there is the spell helper, if you need assistance there. Your number of reaches are determined by your dots in the arcana. So for life magic, you have 5 dots. That means you get 1 reach for 5 dots, and then an additional reach for every dot the spell is lower than 5, all the way down to 5 reaches for a 1 dot spell.
So it's a 4 dot spell.
So you get 2 free reaches before you start causing paradox.
Okay.
And then you have to spend reaches to increase the casting time, and then for this you wouldn't have to increase the duration or the scale or anything.
Okay. But so I want it to be 2 potency, so it heals everything?
Yep, and he has 1 point of lethal, right?
Yes.
Yeah, so that is super easy. Your base potency is equal to your rating, which is 5. Mm. So base, you heal 5 potency worth.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
So 1 reach for quick casting, mm-hmm. and then 1 reach to... Wait, no. I guess I'll add a reach to erase any scars.
Okay.
Or actually, I'll leave the scars, but it'll also heal.
It'll make him sexy.
It'll make him feel
sexy scars.
I'll do the one so that they get a point of willpower back.
Okay. Yep.
And then
so 2 reaches, and then you'd be using Gnosis plus life plus any yantras that you're utilizing.
Oh wow. Plus my rote skill?
Yeah, that would be a yantra.
Okay, so Gnosis is 6, life is 5.
Yeah, like that's
and then I have more 5 from my medicine rote.
Yep.
And do I get 1 more from my knitting needle?
You could use your knitting needle too.
To stab someone.
Okay, and how many successes do I need?
1. Oh. If you get 5 successes, exceptional success, which...
Sometimes happen.
Yeah.
Did you say something about a rote, you re-roll the fails?
Oh yeah, and this is your spell, so you re-roll all failed dice. So I would be surprised if you didn't get an exceptional success. Yeah.
Okay, now I'm trying to remember, is 8 a success?
Yeah, yeah. It's 8, 9, and 10. Tens, you roll the dice again.
Okay, let's see here.
Tens explode, and rotes re-roll.
Yeah, but the rote only re-rolls dice once.
Yeah.
It explodes, it doesn't re-roll.
Are we supposed to be doing that on our rotes, or...?
No, this is only rote that you have made.
I see. I should
Which
get
is
on
something that.
That
you can do, yes.
I should get on that.
Yep.
Okay, 5 successes.
Okay, so exceptional success. That means you recover a point of willpower if you have lost any. And then for spells, you can also choose to either increase one of the spell factors by 1. So like you could increase the potency or the duration of the spell. Or you can choose to refund mana spent to cast it and gain 1 point of mana.
Can I add a reach? Or not.
Or if you can add a feature. Exception. Itself.
Did you say no or not sure?
Not sure.
I guess I'll just take a mana back.
Okay.
It didn't cost 1, but that's okay, right? I still get 1.
Yep, you gain 1.
Okay. There we go. So you're healed and you get a willpower.
That's amazing.
you can add a reach as so. Sorry.
I can't do a reach and get the mana back?
No.
Alright, I won't get the mana back, but I'll make... I'll add the reach. The spell heals damage done by deprivation and charges the subject system as though he had received a full meal and plenty of water.
Okay.
We don't need meals for a year.
That's true. But,
we're not thirsty and tired.
You don't have to eat for a year?
Yeah, we don't have to eat, drink, sleep, close our eyes.
Functions suspended with time magic.
What?
Yeah, this is high-level spellcaster bullshit.
What, are we playing The Sims?
Yeah. okay, so Herb just kind of, like, touches a knitting needle to your, one of the scratch that's probably partially healed on your arm. And it closes.
Mm-hmm.
And you immediately feel like rested and fed, and you get this faint like smell and taste of like freshly baked cookies. As you regain a point of willpower and are satiated.
Wow.
Double satiated. Now you're actually full. You're over full. Yeah, you feel like you have to poop.
Jeez.
Yeah, I feel like you have to poop for a year.
You have to poop for a year, but you can't.
Yeah. Oh my god.
That's torture.
Yep. The longest form of torture.
And strain and strain.
Yep. Sit on a toilet for a year.
Yeah, I don't know if that's exactly how it... time.
That's how we're gonna make it work.
No thanks.
So you mentioned you need to discern if it's the right timeline.
Yeah.
Well, it would probably be easier if you ask me questions instead of me telling you all of history.
Well, right.
All right.
Who's
let's start with did the United States win World War II?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Are there how about the world of magic? Is there still a pentacle and all that?
Yes.
Okay.
What day and time, or what month and date and year did Hitler die?
I probably need to make some kind of history.
Yeah, give me an intelligence and academics roll for that.
Huh.
And it's -3 if you're unskilled.
Yep, that's a chance die.
Okay. I don't know.
I didn't expect you to.
I mean,
what a reasonable answer.
I'm just like, yeah, checks out.
That question is just like two general questions about the general overarching world state, and then what specific day did Hitler die?
Oh shoot. What was the bully's name? I'll just be like, oh hey, Miss Fairy Woman. Oh, what's your name again?
Oh, yes, it's not like you should bother to remember.
Wait. It's Achilles, right?
Yes, it is. Thank you.
Do you know what the Gregorian date is of when Hitler died?
Yes. Oh, yes, that one. I remember him. Quite a mess that ghost was. Still being tormented somewhere in the depths here. What can you do?
Sure.
Are you two Nazis or something? Why are you so concerned with Germany and Hitler?
Because, I mean, it's the exact opposite, actually. I fucking murdered Hitler. I killed him, but good I did. And, you know, may have altered history in the process, but we left some, you know, friends at that time to make sure it didn't go bad. So we're just kind of seeing if it all worked out, and it seems it did. But, you know, a little vague on the time and date, but that's fine.
Hey. Still talking to the fairy woman. I gotta write her name down, because I... Ugh. You want to know?
Did you ever see an angry German with a mustache come down here, fairy lady?
She yes, said she remembered him.
Literally just said that I remember.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Would you kindly tell us the date and time, or does that require payment?
What do you
think? Payment.
What do you think?
Payment.
Well, let's
that
see
is
here.
Correct. I would offer you an answer in exchange for a few drops of your tears.
Do they have to be sorrow? Or could it be pain?
It can be any kind of tears for this. It's not a particularly important thing to me.
Is anything, though?
Well, you have a good point there, but this even less than usual.
All right.
Okay. I guess Sam is going to spend some time trying to cry.
Fuck that. Just poke me in the eye. That is instant tears.
All right.
All right. So, Amnon pokes me in the eye.
So as soon as like a couple of tears trickle down your face, the Achilles reaches a hand out and like brushes them off of your cheek. You get just like the most unpleasant sensation as her finger touches your eye, and you feel it simultaneously like well up with more tears and like dry out.
Oh my god. You siphoned the tears right out of
yeah,
me.
Yeah, you have to like blink a few more times, so like it's like you have sand in your eyes afterwards.
Ow! Ow! Oh, what'd you do?
That will do.
You take 10 aggravated damage.
Yeah. You're now blind.
No, it's just minorly annoying. Yeah. So the tears trickle down her
minor blindness.
And she says, the man who you know as Adolf Hitler was killed April 3rd, 1940.
April 3rd, 1945.
Yeah. So, is that correct day?
That is the correct day for
us.
Altered timeline.
Oh. So we're in the altered timeline.
The timeline that you changed.
Oh. Okay. Yes. Gotcha. Yes. Oh yeah.
The place you want to be.
The place. Yeah. Because if we go back to the original, then we missed or something.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, then you would not have done.
Then we wouldn't have done anything.
Yeah. They would have fucked it up and still had to fight the don't think about it.
Yeah.
Don't even mention.
Oh yeah. No. Don't worry. I know.
All right.
You said you're from Santa Fe.
Yes.
Who do you know in the mage community?
Let me bring up my list of names.
Chance McNally, actually.
Yeah, well, he goes by Cash, but
yeah.
I mean, they keep talking about this movie star. You've never met him. I mean, you know that he's a movie star. You're not aware whether or not he's a mage, but you definitely never met
him. Oh, I didn't know he was a mage.
Yes.
No, he was where we came from.
This you only know a movie star?
No. Let's see. There's. Do you know any of the? So, are you from Santa Fe as well?
Yeah.
All right.
Well,
do you know?
I live there.
Oh, amazing!
Quite well.
We have a small house out on out on the highway. See, I told you it's a small world.
Apparently it is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You didn't like fate magic up in us into going to Santa Fe, did you?
Me?
Yeah. Fate because magic? If you said yes, I would have believed you.
Oh. Yes.
You'd be like, I cast a spell that's going to have us meet someone from Santa Fe and as soon as possible.
Yep.
That feels like what... Actually, Sam is just believes that's what happened without even mentioning it.
That's what happened.
So you know a movie star, you have a house next to the highway, and you're obsessed with Hitler.
No. I was obsessed with killing Hitler. Job done. No more obsession. That is actually checked off my box.
Checked off your box.
Or the box has been ticked. I am no longer obsessing over Hitler.
Oh.
It was just the most
relevant like fact I could think are. Of.
Yeah. Such a man who asked multiple questions about
it's,
Hitler.
Yeah. It's just because that was the most relevant thing we did before we got cast out of time.
Sure.
So we need to know if it worked. All right. What if you were working on, like, the moon landing, and then right before it launched, like, the first Apollo, like, launch, and all those guys were in your responsibility, and then you got kicked out of time. You'd be like, oh, my God, the first thing you'd be asking was, did we land on the moon? Did they make it? Did I send 12 people to their doom? Oh, that's what you'd be asking about. So, I'm asking, did I kill Hitler? Did it work? And did it all go like we planned? That's why I'm obsessed about Hitler, you fuckers. Yeah. What the fuck's Apollo?
Wow. A lot of emotions there.
Yeah. Sorry, I've been under a lot of stress.
Yeah.
Does he have any, like, swastika armbands?
Give me a, give me a wits and empathy roll.
Okay. Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
No successes.
Okay. At this time, you cannot confirm or deny whether this man is a Nazi. It's still up in the air. You don't see any proof to indicate that he is, but you don't see any. You don't feel like there's any solid proof that he isn't.
Okay. Hmm. Okay.
Yeah, I don't know. What are you looking at?
You?
Anyways, made just, you know, in Santa Fe, a Barnabas.
Yeah.
Barnabas?
Sorry.
Right, he's a life mage.
Yes, I know Barnabas.
Oh, interesting.
He's my doctor.
He's your doctor?
Yeah, I pay him to heal me when I get fucked up.
Ah. He doesn't tend to do that very often.
No.
He doesn't?
No.
Awesome. Well, he must like me or something.
Or you pay well.
Or I pay him. Let's see. I'm part of the Adamantine Arrow, if you've heard of their order.
That's...
Let's see here. We also know...
Wait. He's part... Do I know the people in the Adamantine Arrow?
Yeah, you know quite a few of the mages, the local mages in the Adamantine Arrow.
Interesting.
I was,
Okay.
Definitely never seen this guy before.
Yeah. Trained up by, I don't know, some guy who beats the shit out of me. Artemis, she's my director, her handler.
And I know Artemis.
Yeah, you do. You know Artemis.
I know Artemis, but not you.
Oh, well, I mean, relatively new. I don't know how old their order is. I mean, maybe I do, but.
It
was founded around the time that Alexander the Great was alive.
Nice. Okay. So yes, I'm quite new.
Before that,
I should go meet Alexander and become like co-founder of this order.
That he didn't found it, but he was a part of it.
Oh, okay.
Not yes, entirely you're... sure.
You are a young one. That's for sure.
Yes. I'm young but timeless.
Okay. Well, it seems like for the most part, you guys are going to the right place.
I suppose. At least it's not very wrong.
Are you...
We know an Ophelia.
Ophelia, yes. Are you familiar with with her? She's a bit of a local.
Yes, I do know Ophelia.
She was one of the first to help us out, and we bother her a bit more than we should, I suppose.
Ah. So you know some of the older people as well, then?
Yes.
Yeah.
Now, here's a hell of a name. If you know this one, then we are definitely in the right circles. Jericho?
Oh. Of course I know Jericho.
Holy shit.
The handsome man.
Maybe at one time.
You know him?
We've met one of him.
Ah.
Well, we've met two of him.
Yep, we have. We've met two of him and his house.
Yes.
Jericho and other Jericho. I'm surprised I haven't met you guys then.
Man, Jericho was all wigged out and in an alternate reality. We had to go on this like adventure to even find him.
Yep. Trick his house.
That sounds about right.
He was
tricked
quite...
the house?
Yes. He made a sentient house and we had to get it to let us in or something.
Oh yes, he still has his house. Right, Ben?
No, yeah, you know Jericho's house.
Yeah.
Good.
Does it have a name?
Jericho's house.
Does Jericho's house have a name?
Not really.
No.
It's a goetia that is manifested inside of his house through ritual.
You tricked him.
That's right. We only take orders from Jericho, so we had to go get other Jericho and then convince other Jericho to tell the house where Jericho is.
Yeah, so we had other Jericho pose as real Jericho, which he had was fine because he is real Jericho. It's all an ego thing. And plus he enjoyed telling the house to do stuff.
That does sound about right.
So yes, it seems we are heading towards the right time. As long as, you know, there might be minor differences, who knows, but...
Did you get along well with Jericho?
What's that?
Did you get along well with Jericho?
Ah, yes, it was well enough, as one can.
I think we've only talked to him for, in total, a half hour.
Yeah.
It was very information-packed half hour.
We were interesting enough for him to assist. So, there's that.
Interesting.
Herb, why don't you give me a intelligence and... let's go... Wits and intelligence roll.
Alright, I'm gonna use a willpower.
Don't you dare figure out what he was assisting us with.
That's three more?
Here you go.
Right?
Yes, plus three dice for spending a little
time. Yeah, I mean, there's still some. It's just not, it's ashy. It's a little wary. A little ashy.
Five successes.
Okay. So
wait,
this...
do I get my willpower back?
Yeah, you do, actually.
Excellent.
So this man Gray,
that's
he kind of reminds you of someone who you've known for quite some time. one of the, a member of the Adamantine Arrow. Just similar demeanor, maybe. I mean, he's also an acanthus. Maybe that's it.
No way.
What's similar? Well, with an exceptional success, I'd say you also feel like there's a similar kind of like energy to him as well, just like the twinkle in his eye kind of thing. Something what? More than just personality.
What's the name of the other person?
Knave.
That's not great.
Well, you're unless right. You say something, we don't know that.
What?
Unless she says something, we don't know this.
I know. That's just me.
You do remind me of somebody that I know.
Oh. Well, I'm sure. What
is?
I'm sure legends.
What do I know
were,
about this person?
I'm sure Sorry. Legends were made of me, and people tried
what
to emulate.
You know about this person?
Yeah.
He is a senior member of the Adamantine Arrow. Not really. He doesn't really have any like position in the order. By choice. Tends to be a little bit of a rebellious sort. But he's lived in Santa Fe for a long, long time. Since before you've lived there. And occasionally goes off on expeditions traipsing about. You heard the times when you were younger, he was dealing with some stuff related to Celesti, Abyss Worshippers.
Do you know Knave?
I look at frickin' Gray, excuse me.
Yeah.
And look back at her and be like, yes, we do.
This one reminds me of him quite a bit.
I see.
Do they seem like they're not just jolly talking anymore?
Yeah, my eyes just went wide and I just let Amadine talk now.
Is something wrong?
No, something might be very right.
I think you're a little too young to be speaking so cryptically.
What, me?
He's like 60.
I think I'm still older than you.
I could change that.
I can too, if I wanted to.
Yeah, that's nice.
Nave,
can you reverse age stuff?
I believe so.
With like,
I can regenerate.
Cool.
And like grow back organs.
You can do a Genkai. That's cool. Yeah, that's where you just get back to your peak physical performance.
Yes, we know Knave. Excuse me. He was one of the friends we mentioned earlier that we left behind after our expedition to kill Hitler and the Celestis. So.
Interesting. I know he's older than, like, he's been around much longer than me. He doesn't talk about Hitler like you, though.
Well, it just happened not even yesterday for me, so I'm sure it's been longer for him.
Yeah. Oh, no. See, how long have we been trying to work our way back to reality?
You have literally no idea, because part of that time, all of that time, there's been no day-night cycle.
There's been no time. All of that time, there's been no time.
And we've not been tired or taken a nap.
Yeah, you literally haven't slept for... You have no idea.
Yep. I mean, I have the timing, but it's like, okay, I'll take a guess. It's been a week.
I mean, I have my cell phone, I guess, but I'm sure the battery...
It's been weeks, probably.
Yeah. But it was the last... We've done a few things, but it was the last thing we've done.
Yeah, it has been plus infinity.
Yep. It's been infinity, give or take a couple weeks.
Yeah, infinity plus 14.
Yep. That's the kind of timescale we're living on right now.
Take that, Ackles. Just kidding.
For a time mage, you seem not to know much about it.
Yeah. Well, you know, once you live outside of it, it's hard to gauge.
Interesting. So it seems like I'm either missing from where you're from, and you're missing from where I'm from.
Yes, we're both trying to get back to the same place, I believe.
Why don't you try to go back to your world?
Then everything we did would be pointless. I know.
Yeah, no, we don't want to do that.
Yeah. We went a long, long way to get to where we are now. It'd be better if we just died here than made it back to our original time.
And you might get your wish.
I knew Ackles was going to chime in.
Yeah.
I knew it.
I mean, that was easy. That was too easy.
Yeah. I was about to say my character like looked at Ackles.
You're gonna set me off like that.
Yeah. But it's true. So,
as she says that, you look up and you notice that there is like a off to the side of the tunnel. There is a kind of rocky gray like beach made out of like gray sand and some like stones. That leads up to the wall of the cavern, which there are several sort of like tunnels carved into the rock. It says, "Here you are. Our journey ends here. Well, your journey ends here. My journey is going to continue ad infinitum."
Is there anything you would like to keep your endless time here a little more entertaining? I couldn't think of anything, of a third thing.
Perhaps a magical salamander?
No. I have no need of salamanders or things.
From the best goddamn time mage.
Now you're talking, and I puff my collar out a little bit.
Well, you could give her another tear for the road, and I'll poke him in the eye.
I mean, I'll take it.
And I poke your eye quite dexterously.
Old jab.
Old lady bony finger.
Like, the perfect, just quick. Oh.
Just enough to give you a little tear trickle down.
Ah!
For being rude to her.
I guess since it's there, you can have it.
This time she just holds a hand underneath your chin, and the tear trickles down your cheek and drips onto her hand. And says, "Very well, off you go.
Enjoy. Thanks."
"I won't."
That's a shame.
No, it's nothing really.
It's neither a thing nor a thing. It's nothing.
Yep. So you disembark from the ferry via the River Acheron. And Achilles kind of looks at you and says, "Oh, well, have a good time being relentlessly hunted by the guardians of the underworld."
It was nice meeting you.
Oh, we will.
Something meeting you.
We will have a good time going and being hunted and surviving and meeting our goals.
And good for you. And she pushes the ferry off from the shoreline with the oar.
Yeah. Take I know what you were doing.
Dearie.
And mist begins to gather around the boat as it heads further down the brackish gray river.
There's people like you on Earth.
You hear no response, except for the faint sigh of quiet exasperation.
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. So we're here.
Right. Let's see here. None shall let us shade pass from the underworld. None shall eat living without his exact payment. Receive and drink what is put before you. You must not interact with the plague ones.
No.
You must grant no succor to those who chanting to myself, I guess. Anyways.
Well, What does it look like around here?
So what you see before you is it's just like a cavern wall that heads into like several tunnels. And as you kind of approach and you get closer and you feel like kind of like the sounds of the river water kind of lapping up against the shore. Quiet, and it just seems very silent.
Can I like see ghosts if I activate my mage sight, or do I not have the right?
That would be death sight. However, since you are in the underworld, ghosts are they are visible to everyone because you're in the underworld. You're in there where they are supposed to be.
It's us that are invisible. They can't see us.
So they are like corporeal here.
We're incorporeal.
Most of the time. You guys are corporeal as well.
Oh no, I figured just the ghosts. It's a opposite thing.
Okay.
Well, she seemed nice. The boat lady.
Yeah. Kind of sad.
Yeah. A little.
So you're a fate mage.
People who want to be sad.
I never said that.
Your friend did.
You traitor.
That's and you right. Admitted to it.
Just now. And if it was
you
earlier,
said you
I wasn't
said
paying attention.
Used your fate magic to come to the right place.
Oh, yes, now I remember. Son of a bitch.
All well, right. Could you use your fate magic to help us select which door to go down to accomplish my goals?
Yeah, I believe I could do that. Yeah, it's fake magic.
You say fake?
Yep. It's sorry, you misheard him. I'm a master in fake magic.
Wow.
Like, you know, stage magic and stuff. I can make an elephant disappear. Ooh.
That sounds impressive, actually.
Elephant.
Elephants are quite large.
I mean, what's his ass? David Copperfield can make a 747 disappear. So.
I don't think he exists in my world.
Oh, really?
I don't know. I don't really watch magic.
Awesome. However, I think David Copperfield is... His age demographic is in the older crowd. The ladies love him.
I have my eyes set on someone else.
Chris Angel.
Yes, Angel.
Chris Angel, mind freak.
Yeah. Yep, that's exactly what I meant.
Yep. Fairy
Those magicians.
Yep. Those fake magicians. Now.
So you cannot help with this, is what you're saying?
Yes, I cannot help. I have fake magic. No, I can. Is it the thing that lets us like choose the right path, or would lucky number work on a door?
I don't think lucky.
I didn't think so either. I do have that one up right now. Momentary flux that says my actions are good or bad. So if I go up to each door and go to open it, like, and you
there's
know,
no door. It's just a passage down.
Or sorry, if I go into each like passageway and like act as if I'm, you know, intent to go on entering that one, do I get a sign of don't?
You don't get any particular vibe one way or another, just kind of approaching.
Okay. Then, how long did the boat ride take? Longer than an hour, I'm assuming?
Probably about an hour.
Ooh, so prophecy's out then.
Yep. All right. Yeah, anything that lasted for a scene is gone.
Okay. Oh, hold on. One, I'm in time. I need to go to fate. Chicka 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 chow. Is it exceptional luck? No, it's. Oh, superlative luck. Oh my god, I said the word right. Usually I'm over here superlative.
Super latte.
Oh, that's not it either. Damn it. That's just a good one.
So you're trying to cast a spell to do what exactly?
Choose the right door.
What are you trying to find?
Or choose the right pathway. I don't know. What did you ask, Herb?
Which path to go down to accomplish my goals?
Oh, I could cast that on you. But it's better if you just kind of don't really even know what's going on, because then you just kind of follow your instincts and go the way you feel is right.
So I need to not know that you're going to cast this spell?
No, it doesn't really matter. It's just, I think it works better if you don't know.
I mean, I know now.
Right. You're not wrong. So,
even if I closed my eyes, I'd still know what you were doing.
Okay, so we go back in time right to the before this conversation happens.
Okay, sure. Boom. Cast Shifting Sands.
Yup. And now, ask me, so now we're right at the end of that question. And I say no.
Goals.
I say no, sorry, I can't. You're just gonna have to pick one. And then I cast a spell.
All right. And Gray keeps this little joke to himself, as he does many things.
I mean, it seems like a pretty standard thing for somebody.
Right.
Is in the... What is it? It's not... Or the path that you are in.
Right. I think it just is... Serendipity, but or no.
Shifting the odds.
Is that what it is?
You could use that.
Okay.
Ooh. Although I don't know, you might need more details to cast that. Alternatively, you could go with Strings of Fate with a larger scale thing.
That's it. That's what I want.
Strings of Fate.
Yep, that's what I think I cast on the guy earlier when we were going through the hedge maze.
Yep.
Here you go. So he was picking the right, because he never knew it was cast on him. So he was just picking the right path without, you know, just by doing it.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So. What the fuck? Flintstone? Okay. The reach lets. The spell presents opportunities to work toward the specific.